안녕하세요. 조코딩입니다. 오늘은 IBM AI 서밋 코리아 행사에서 아시아 태평양 대표를 맡고 계신 한스님을 모시고 네, 인터뷰를 진행해 보려고 하는데요. Hello Hans, nice to meet you.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Can you briefly introduce yourself?
So my name is Hans Dekkers. I'm the general manager for IBM in Asia Pacific.
Let's begin with something personal to
okay.
set the tone.
All right.
I believe that you are an avid coder yourself, despite your busy schedule. Tell us a little about your own coding journey and any advice you might have for coders in our audience on picking up relevant skills to work alongside AI with new trends like vibe coding.
So I still tinker around on the web and on my machines. As a young kid, I did a lot more, right? So first Commodore, the first computers, we played around with easy languages like Pascal, C++. In the end, it became Java, .NET, and then I'm a big fan of Python, actually. I mean, where does coding start? It starts with playing around on Raspberry Pis, enhancing your audio. It's about developing automations that don't work in your home. So you use Home Assistant, you use Homey, you use different platforms, and you make stuff work. Mm-hmm. You play around with it, right? And I was actually this weekend, I used to have a Commodore 64, which is an old computer.
Oh.
It goes way back.
Uh-huh.
And as a young kid, we used to play games on it. And one of those games was a platform game. Gina Girls, I think, was the name of the game. Anyhow, the game always crashed in level 32. Always crashed. There was a bug in it. And I woke up Saturday night, I said, there was a bug in that game. Mm-hmm. Can I, using AI, actually retrace that bug and actually fix it? It's like 30 years ago, right? So a long time ago. Dug up the game, got the source code, started asking AI to help me reprogram the game. And then it really opened up for me, because you can then change color of the main character. You can start playing around, because it's open source today. So you could fix the game you played 20, 25 years ago using AI. So once in a while, I still tinker around, but also on bigger projects. I'm a big believer in open source and contributing, working on some cancer research on breast cancers. So yeah, I still play around a lot. You have to stay curious. Yeah.
Speaking of coders and skills, education is a key enabler.
Right.
IBM is investing in AI education with Skills Build and AI Academy. How do you see AI-related education becoming a platform to build the workforce of tomorrow?
So I believe these initiatives, IBM's initiatives across the world, are really, really important. Mm-hmm. We're schooling millions of people on these technologies, IBM products, but also wider overall technologies. But in the end, I believe it's really on skills, right? One is content. You need to learn the profession, you need to learn the detail. But in the end, I believe it comes down to two core skills of the future. One is what I call critical thinking. The other one is really curiosity, right? Do you have the mind to go and solve the world's biggest problem? Those two are, to me, the most important skills.
And developers in Asia are already embracing this shift. Let's talk about their role in shaping the future. Asia has emerged as a hub for technology-driven innovation, especially with open source AI being easily accessible to the large cohort of developers here. What are your views on the role of Asian developers in the evolving AI landscape?
I think the thing I've seen the most, which I love the most, is the people in Asia, the coders, the programmers, very pragmatic. So they're very pragmatic in embracing the technologies that are at hand, using it for real problem solving. They don't overthink it, they become really pragmatic. And back to your open source AI comment, I think in this region, in the Asia region, the adoption of models in China, also India, here in Korea, in ASEAN, I see a lot of models coming up that are homemade, home optimized, and that is being embraced widely by the community. So it's actually a beautiful thing, because it's an open source community built in Asia, more so than anywhere else in the world. And also we as an IBM company believe in that open stack, that open power of a multitude of people, of sharing, of transparency. And I believe Asia is primed for that new era of development. I'm very enthusiastic about what I'm seeing here in Asia.
And zooming out a bit, how does IBM see Asia Pacific's role in this transformation? What do you see as the role of Asia Pacific as an engine for IBM's future?
I mean, it's absolutely important. I think it's going to be the growth engine for us as a company. 60% of the GDP growth sits in APAC. If you look at the population, you look at the demographics of the economies that exist here, there is an incredible amount of growth happening in Asia. Combine that with open source, combine that with the education of the folks, the accessibility of technology. I believe these are all core ingredients for the future as the Asian nations develop. And we as an IBM company are part of that and have been part of that for decades. And we are incredibly enthused about what's going to happen in the next 10 years here in Asia. So it's a big part of our ambitions here.
Now, let's shift to IBM's broader vision for the future of work. What is IBM's vision for the era of agentic AI? What will change for the workforce, both for technology and non-technology workers?
I mean, let's go back a little bit on the earlier steps in AI, where we did first experimentation, we did the first RAG cases. It's quickly evolving into coding, where AI is being used everywhere in the coding realm. The next steps, the next big unlock is really the agentic piece. And every software provider, in our view, will have their own agents. Everyone is creating their own agents. But we believe that the creation of agents is one thing. The orchestration of agents across the full enterprise landscape is a big pivotal point. And we have a platform called WatsonX Orchestrate, where we have over 1,000 agents that can connect of different vendors, IBMs and others, to orchestrate the agents for the enterprise, to then have that platform actually cooperate, coexist with your physical world of employees, of systems, of processes. And we believe that that supplementation of agentic and workforce is going to be an extremely powerful force for enterprises in the future.
Finally, let's look ahead to the next frontier, quantum computing. Quantum computing is an emerging area of technological interest in Asia. How can developers in Korea and Asia Pacific leverage IBM's work in this area to be ready for quantum era?
That's a good question. Maybe first, there are three big emerging technologies today. AI, hybrid cloud, and then the third one is quantum computing. And quantum computing is coming, and it's coming very fast. We believe commercially viable in 2 to 3 years. It's a complete new paradigm. It will work in coexistence with traditional compute. We will have quantum compute, qubit. How do you get started? You can sign up today and understand Qiskit, which is our programming platform. It's the platform that you can use to communicate with a quantum computer.
Everyone can use
that. Everyone can use, everyone can start learning. We're working with universities, with research institutions to get people educated, to get inputs from the community to co-build the next era of quantum-based software, and that's why we created Qiskit. So if you want to get started, ibm.com/quantum, search for Qiskit, download the SDK, and get going.
Wow. Your view is in 3 years, the quantum computing can be very practical?
It can be put to practical use. We believe 3 to 5 years is a good time frame.
Wow. Do you expect the quantum computer will exceed the traditional computer?
First of all, a quantum computer will be used to solve very different problems. So to put them head to head is not a good compare. It will solve very different problems that we haven't really been able to solve on traditional computers. So it will be used for a different type of problem. And yes, when it gets to that scale a couple of years from now, I think we can solve some very meaningful problems that we haven't been able to solve with traditional computing.
Wow. Thank you for your time. And lastly, could you say something to my subscribers for encouragement?
So, dear coders, stay hungry, mm-hmm. Stay energized, and make the most of the next decade because technology is gonna change the world.
Mm. Oh, great. Thank you.
Thank you.